En 2005, une expertise
In 2005, a global assessment was conducted by more than 1,300 scientists from across the world, the Millennium Ecosystem Assessment, an in-depth study showing the status of the various ecosystems that are inhabited by man. Ecosystems are really biodiversity at play in the air, on the ground, underground, in the seas, so that all of the living planet can function. Now, this collective assessment and expertise documented, showed the ecosystemic services provided by the ecosystems. There are several kinds of services. The first ones are very simple, easy to understand. This is all about our everyday life. Services such as production and supply. These services feed us, allow us to wear clothes or keep ourselves warm with fire and draw water from wells. The ecosystem provides those services to us to live, not only for man, but to other living species as well. The other group of services is more difficult to apprehend. We're talking about support services, the large cycles of life, the hydrogeochemical cycles, the main elements, the carbon cycle, the nitrogen cycle, the water cycle within ecosystems. And these big cycles determine the ecosystem's capacity to provide production services, the big support cycles. Another set of services are the regulation services, services that allow the ecosystem to act as a buffer of the effect on climate on the local level, on the regional level. There are parameters that may have an impact on the climate. Forest evaporating and playing a role in the water cycle or rain cycle. This is a service provided by the ecosystem. Pollinization provided by bees for flower plants is important. 75% of cultivated plants are pollinized by pollinator insects. All of these regulation services are very important, although they are not visible at first glance when we look at an ecosystem. And finally, and this is maybe more subtle, but very important for man, all services provided by the ecosystems for cultural users, symbolic and leisure users. The town dweller who likes to walk across a preserved natural landscape, the painter painting a beautiful landscape, or man simply watching nature or beautiful agricultural landscapes. These are services provided by the ecosystems. So the four groups of ecosystemic services play an essential role, not only to keep the planet functioning adequately and to allow it its resilience, but also for human well-being. The collective expertise showed the connection between the various services and the various constituting elements for human well-being. What it boils down to is that although we may observe that in modern life, unfortunately, we don't pay sufficient attention to ecosystems, ecosystems are an absolutely essential element of human well-being. We know about bees and the fact that bee population is decreasing, and this is a threat to pollination. In some countries south of China, people have to replace the pollinator insects and they have to pollinize orchards by hand. And this shows the economic impact of the disappearance of an ecosystemic service such as pollination, and it means thousands, tens of thousands of billion euros. Economic, ecological systems services have an impact on our daily life, and the agricultural space does not escape the rule. It is managed by ecosystemic rules and services. Biodiversity, the role played by biodiversity, which was domesticated and selected by man, or the association between species, but agriculture depends, is driven by all of the ecosystemic services. And if those services become eroded, and they have already become eroded in sometimes in an irreversible way, as was shown by the expertise, production and agriculture will suffer. industrial agriculture has developed
a
new form of relationship with the ecosystem and ecosystem services. Ever since positivism at the end of the 19th century, where chemical science triumphed and denied the biological and living concept of cultivated spaces, where people thought that all you had to do was pay back to the soil what you had borrowed in order to maintain stability in the yield. We now are beginning to realize that the various ways to cultivate land have different impacts on the ecosystems and their services rendered by these ecosystems. A very mechanized agriculture with a single genotype of plant over hundreds of thousands of hectares with chemical fertilizers and pesticides to protect the crop. This means that the ecosystemic services are impoverished compared with a much more diversified type of agriculture, the production of which depends much more on ecosystem services. Modern agriculture in industrialized countries have denied the living aspect of agriculture, and this has damaged ecosystemic services nowadays.